Once free charge carriers are generated, they can recombine again. But how does this recombination work? What are the possible recombination mechanisms in a solar cell? How do they work? What are the underlying mechanisms? And what is the recombination rate of each mechanism? These questions will be answered in the following two videos. First, we will identify three different recombination processes. Subsequently, we will conceptualize the underlying mechanism of each recombination process, and finally, we will discuss the recombination rate of each process and discuss how to calculate them. Before we dive into the recombination mechanisms, let's briefly recap what recombination means. As we discussed in the previous video, recombination is the annihilation of free charge carriers. There are three different recombination processes: radiative, Auger, and Shockley-Retold recombination. In this video, we will discuss radiative recombination and Auger recombination only, while Shockley-Retold recombination will be discussed in the next video. Let's start with radiative recombination. In radiative recombination, the energy of the recombination process between an electron and a hole is emitted as a photon after recombination. The energy of this photon is a bit higher than the energy of the band gap of the semiconductor material, e.g., but for simplicity, we can consider this energy to be equal to the band gap energy. Radiative recombination is, in fact, the mechanism that light-emitting diodes or LEDs utilize. Radiative recombination is very significant in direct bandgap semiconductors, but relatively rare in indirect bandgap semiconductors like crystalline silicon. The recombination rate for radiative recombination is given by the following formula. This rate is proportional to the concentration of electrons N in the conduction band and holes P in the valence band. The equilibrium concentrations N0 and P0 need to be subtracted, which leaves us with the net recombination rate. Beta in this equation is a proportionality factor and is material dependent. Depending on the illumination conditions and on the material parameters, this expression can be simplified. For example, let's look at an N-type semiconductor under low-level injection. Here, the change in free electron concentration, delta N, is negligible compared to the total electron concentration, N. Additionally, the concentration of holes is much lower than the concentration of electrons, as electrons are the majority charge carriers and holes are the minority charge carriers in this N-type material. This leads to the following expression, where the term between parentheses is effectively the excess free hole concentration. This leaves us with the radiative recombination rate for N-type semiconductors under low-level injection. A similar derivation can be applied to P-type semiconductors, resulting in the following equation where N and P are interchanged. The next process through which excited charge carriers can recombine is Auger recombination. Auger recombination is a three-particle process. The momentum and energy of the recombining hole and the electron are transferred to another electron or hole. This third particle is excited deeper into the respective band and relaxes again by a process called thermalization. In this thermalization process, this free electron, in essence, loses some of its energy in interactions with the crystal lattice. When the third particle is an electron, it is an electron-electron-hole process, which will be abbreviated as EEH. If the third particle is a hole, it is an electron-hole-hole process, which will be abbreviated by EHH. Auger recombination strongly depends on the charge carrier densities, since a higher concentration increases the probability that the three carriers can interact in this way. Therefore, the recombination rate of the EEH process is given by the following equation. The recombination rate is proportional to the square of the electron concentration n, since two electrons are involved in the process. The concentration of holes p is also important due to the fact that one hole is necessary for Auger recombination to take place. Cn is a proportionality constant. For the EHH process, the hole concentration is squared, while the electron concentration is not, and Cp is a proportionality constant for EHH-Auger recombination. By combining both processes, the recombination rate of Auger recombination is obtained. We will now simplify the recombination rate for N and P-type materials. If we look at a strongly doped N-type material under low-level injection, we can assume that the electron density N is equal to the donor concentration ND, and that the hole concentration P is negligible compared to the electron concentration N. This leads to an Auger recombination rate that is dominated by the EEH process. Therefore, this simplified expression can be used to calculate the Auger recombination rate for N-type materials. The same derivation can be performed for P-type materials, resulting in the following expression. In this case, the recombination rate is proportional to the concentration of acceptors, Na square, and to the electron concentration, N. In summary, we have seen that we can distinguish three recombination processes. The mechanisms underlying radiative and Auger recombination were discussed, and we now understand their recombination rates. The most important recombination mechanism for silicon-based solar cells, Shockley-Reed-Hall recombination, will be discussed in the next video.